Hello students, welcome to the chemistry class. Let's start this session with a quote. Nothing is interest unless you are willing. Nothing is interest unless you are willing. Let's move on to the session. Take one apple, cut down into two halves. Take one part of it, further cut down into smaller and smaller pieces. At one point of time, you cannot further cut down, right? So the finest particle or the smallest particle which is indivisible is said to be atom. In today's class, we are going to learn a new chapter which is atoms and molecules. So what is atom? Atom is the smallest particle and it is made up of electron and proton and neutron. Here the electron is revolving around the nucleus, whereas proton and neutron is present at the center of the nucleus. In BC, Greek philosopher came up with an idea about atom. But the theory was a failure because that theory was based on philosophy. It was not based on scientific. Then John Dalton, J.J. Thomson, Rutherford, Bohr, Sommerfeld came up with their ideas about the structure of an atom. There is some drawbacks in their theory. In order to overcome these drawbacks, modern atomic theory was put forward. Let's see the postulates of modern atomic theory. The first one is, atom is no longer indivisible. It is made up of subatomic particles like electron, proton and neutron. Next postulate is isotopes. Atoms of the same element have same atomic number but different mass number. For an example, hydrogen, deuterium, tritium. All these elements have same atomic number 1 but different mass number. The isotope of hydrogen is deuterium and tritium. Next one is isobars. Atoms of different element but have same mass number is said to be isobars. For an example, argon and calcium. They have same mass number 40 but different atomic number. Next postulate is artificial transmutation. What is artificial transmutation? The conversion of one element into another element by artificial method is said to be artificial transmutation. For an example, if you bombard alpha particle with nitrogen, you will get oxygen. Okay, this is an example for artificial transmutation. Next, atom is not always combined in a simple whole number ratio like glucose. The formula for glucose is C6H12O6. If you simplify, you will get 1:2:1. So for every compound or for every molecule, the atoms will not be combined in a simple whole number ratio. Okay, for an example, sucrose, the formula is C12H22O11. So if you simplify, you will get 12:22:11. Okay, there is no simple whole number ratio. Okay, so now you can understand, atoms cannot combine in a simple whole number ratio. Then atoms involve in a chemical reaction. Okay, if we know that two atoms of chlorine will give chlorine molecule. Okay, next, the mass of an atom converted into energy which is said to be E equal to mc square. These are the postulates of atomic theory. Next, we have a car, chair and a steam. So it is an example of matter. So everything in the world around us is made up of matter. So what is matter? Anything which has mass and occupies space is said to be matter. Matter is made up of atom. That's why we call atom is the building block of matter. The structure of an atom is shown here. We know that electrons revolve around the nucleus, whereas a neutron and a proton present at the center of the nucleus. Next, here you have one element. The atomic number is 2. The sum of proton and neutron is 4. Because here you have 2 proton and 2 neutron. Okay, so the sum of proton and neutron is said to be mass number. Here you have another element which is oxygen. Here the proton is 8, neutron is 8. So the mass number is 16. So mass number is represented by A, which is equal to number of proton and number of neutron. If you went to a market for buying vegetables, okay, how can you measure the weight of an vegetable? By using weighing machine with the help of kg stone, right? One side you place a kg stone and 1 kg stone, other side you place vegetables. If both sides are in equilibrium or both sides are balanced, then it is said to be 1 kg of stone is equal to 1 kg of tomato or any kind of vegetables. So this is the way you measure the weight of an vegetables. Okay, so here you compare the weight of vegetables with the kg stone. So how can you measure the atom? How can you measure the mass of an atom? So you can use this method. Whether it is helpful for you to determine the mass of an atom? No, because the size of an atom is very small. So we cannot determine by this method with the kg stone. Okay, so what should we do by using relative atomic mass? So one side you place one hydrogen atom, other side you place one hydrogen atom. Now both are in equilibrium. So the one hydrogen atom is equal to one hydrogen atom. Suppose if you are placing lithium atom on another side, next another side you have to place 6 times of hydrogen atom, because 6 units of hydrogen is equal to 1 lithium. Okay, but this method was failure. Okay, so next, a few more scientists used oxygen as the standard unit. Okay, but that also failure. Then they use carbon, C12, okay, C12 as the standard unit. In vegetables they use 1 kg stone, right? In chemistry, they, for measuring mass of an atom, they use C12 as the standard unit. So they compare the mass of an atom with C12. Okay, now the C12 is divided by 12. Okay, so it divided into 12 parts. So now you can place, instead of C12, 12 units of carbon. Okay, instead of placing carbon 12, you have to use 12 units of carbon like this. Okay, next, if you take one part of C12, that is said to be atomic mass unit. So which is one part of the 12 is said to be one atomic mass unit. Okay, or people nowadays they do not use the word atomic mass unit, they specify one unified unit. So this is the important one. I repeat, if you take one part from the carbon 12, okay, if you take one part from the carbon 12, okay, that is said to be 1 AMU or 1 U. Okay, next, so in next you have to find out the other elements mass, right? So one side I'm placing C12 units. Okay, next side I have oxygen atom. Oxygen atom is heavier, that's why here it is imbalance. So what should I do? I have to place 4 more carbon units. Now it is balanced. Okay, so the relative atomic mass of oxygen is 16. So the relative atomic mass is represented by AR. So the relative atomic mass of oxygen is 16. One side I have placed 16 units of carbon, other side I have oxygen. Next, here I am using lithium. I want to find out the relative mass of lithium. Okay, another side I place a carbon 12 units. Here also imbalance create. What I should do? I have to remove 6 units of carbon. Now you compare. So both sides are in equilibrium because here I have 6 units of carbon and which is equal to lithium. So the relative atomic mass of lithium is 6. Here there is mistake. Okay, next. So here I am giving here there is an formula for relative atomic mass. Relative atomic mass is equal to average mass of the isotopes of the element divided by the 1/12th of the mass of one carbon 12 atom. Otherwise, you can use this formula also. Average relative atomic mass is equal to average mass of the isotopes of the element into 12 divided by the mass of one carbon 12 atom. Okay. So how can you find out the how can you measure the atomic masses or mass of an atom, right? By using mass spectroscopy, okay, or mass spectrometry method, you can find out the mass of an atom. Next, here they list out the few elements with their relative atomic mass. Okay, for hydrogen 1, if you get 1.001 or 12.63, so they round off, okay? They round off and give the whole number ratio. Except chlorine, they have given, right, okay? Hydrogen 1, carbon 12, nitrogen 14, like that. If you, there is no unit for atomic, relative atomic mass. If you give a gram to this relative atomic mass, then it is said to be gram atomic mass. If you said in a, if you measure in a atomic mass unit, then you have to mentioned as U. Okay, 1U, 12U, like that. Okay, I hope you will understand the concepts of modern atomic theory and their postulates and relative atomic mass. Okay. Thank you.